Hi, it's Barton Jennings here from Lung and Sleep. In this short video, I just want to explain to you a condition called excessive dynamic airway collapse, or often abbreviated to EDAC. This is a condition where the central airways, mostly the trachea and main bronchi, close excessively during expiration or during coughing. So what should happen when we breathe normally is that as we breathe in, our airways open up, and when we breathe out, our airways just close a little bit due to the change in pressure within our chest. And the central airways, the trachea and main bronchi and lobar bronchi, have cartilage around them, or around most of them, to hold them open. And the posterior wall of those airways is made up of muscle. And so that muscle bows in just a little bit during expiration. Sometimes, however, that posterior muscle bows in much more than it should, sometimes up to half or even 90% of the airway lumen. Occasionally during coughing or during respiration, patient's airways may actually close completely during expiration or breathing out. Now this can cause a lot of problems. Firstly, if the airway collapses, it can cause irritation to the central airway, which irritates cough receptors and causes a lot of cough. And so these patients often present with cough. And the cough tends to potentiate itself because the more you cough, the more airway collapse there is. And if you can imagine that your airway walls, which are opening up when you breathe in and then closing and hitting into each other, that continual irritation of the airway walls can cause ongoing cough. So patients often describe, they start coughing and then they have a real episode of cough that they can't settle down. It also causes retention of a lot of secretions. So if we've got an infection in our lung, or our lungs producing increasing amounts of mucus in the setting of lung diseases like COPD or bronchiectasis, then it's important to be able to clear those secretions, and we do that through deep breathing and coughing. However, if you cough and your airways collapse completely, then we can't clear those secretions. And if the secretions stay in the airway, then they can become infected, and then it makes it difficult to clear the infection. So this is a condition that causes a lot of patients to feel quite unwell, causes a lot of cough, a lot of infection. So it's a good one to think about in those patients who have those symptoms. Anyway, I've got some videos now of bronchoscopy, because during bronchoscopy is the perfect time to be able to see exactly what's happening to the airways. And this is really useful, I think, to understand what's happening in these patients with excessive dynamic airway collapse. I hope you find it useful. Here is a normal airway. There's some clear secretion, which is airway surfactant. This is the left lung, left lower lobe, coming back to the trachea and right main bronchus now. And you can see that the airways are open during quiet respiration. Here's a patient with excessive dynamic airway collapse, and on expiration, the posterior trachea wall is coming right forwards and almost completely closing the central airways. The airways look quite inflamed. Here's another patient where the posterior trachea wall is really bowing in, and there's a little benign nodule on the trachea as well. Here's a case of a patient when they cough, their posterior trachea really bows in and almost completely obstructs the central airways. So you could imagine how difficult this would make it to clear secretions if during coughing the airway is collapsing, as it is in this case. And the cough also causes a lot of tracheal irritation and inflammation and causes ongoing cough. In this case, this patient has just mild dynamic collapse of the trachea, not too bad at all. As we go down to the left main bronchus, you can see some mucus secretions, but the left main bronchus is becoming quite narrow on expiration, and the left lower lobe is almost completely closing and is full of mucus. So this patient has a great deal of difficulty in clearing that secretion, so that contributes to ongoing infection. And down the right main bronchus here, once again, the right lower lobe is becoming very narrow during expiration, just on quiet breathing. So when there's coughing, this expiratory collapse is further exaggerated and made even worse. And so the ability to cough up that secretion is made very, very difficult. I'll go back to the trachea there, and you can see that there's a moderate degree of collapse. This is the same patient after the secretions have been suctioned, and you can see that the airway has become quite inflamed and red. The left main bronchus is really collapsing during quiet respiration to the point where the left main bronchus almost completely closes. So there you go. There are a few cases showing the bronchoscopic images of patients with excessive dynamic airway collapse. And I think this helps understand what's going on in patients like this who have this condition and why they get a lot of cough and why they get a lot of infection. But there are some good treatments for this, and a lot of that involves chest physiotherapy exercises, and we can certainly help with those if that is occurring. So it's an important condition to think about in patients who do have a lot of cough and a lot of chest infection, to consider bronchoscopy to look for this condition called EDAC. And if we find it, then there are certainly things that we can do to help. Anyway, I hope you found that useful. I'll see you later.